In this video, we are going to study about the permeability factors and the thermal properties of the concrete. So what is the strength of concrete? The compressive strength of the concrete is one of the most important and useful properties of concrete. In most structural applications, concrete is employed primarily to resist the compressive stresses. So again and again I am saying that as per IS 456 we are taking some samples and we are testing after the 28th day in the lab as well as in the site using CTM. So that plays a major role to know about whether the strength aspect has been satisfied for the concrete which has been laid in the project. So in most structural applications concrete will also always undergo primarily to resist the compressive stresses. So depends on your compressive strength, the durability of the structure can be easily identified. In most structural applications, concrete is employed primarily to resist compressive stresses. That's what I said. In those cases where strength in tension or in shear is of primary importance, the compressive strength is frequently used as measure of these properties. Depends on the projects and depends on the loading condition and depends on the types of loading. In some point it may lead to point load and some place it may lead to UDL, some places it may lead to UVL. So depends on the stresses and also some torsional loadings and based on some conditions, moment of inertia also, it may lead to different in stresses. So where the strength in tension or in shear, the primary importance has been given to the compression. So that's why we are always taking care about the compression test of the sample to decide the strength as well as the durability of the concrete. The compressive strength of concrete is generally determined by testing cubes or even sometimes cylinders made in laboratory or field or cores drilled from modern concrete in the site. So normally we used to take samples in form of cubes or cylinders, and 99% we used to take only cubes in the field to test and identify the strength of the concrete. If you are not taken that, then we want to have drilled samples from by methodology of core cutting equipment, so that the cores can be taken from the existing concrete structure and it can be tested in the laboratory. So that will be in terms of cylindrical shape to identify the strength of the concrete. Strength of concrete is its resistance to rupture. It may be measured in number of ways, such as strength in compression, electron strength in tension or even shear or in terms of flexure. All those indicate strength with reference to particular method of testing. So depends on the methodology of testing, we can identify the strength. Normally beams means we used to undergo with respect to flexure, and depends on the other conditions and other samples we are going to test in case of compression as well as tension in terms of shear. Normally in beams shear we undergo shear testing also, or in terms of flexure also. So that depends on the failure also, we can identify the types of structure or types of loading also. So this indicates with the particular method of the testing. So normally for beams we adapt with respect to flexural testing. When concrete fails under a compressive load, the failure is essentially a mixture of crushing and shear failure. So whatever load we are obtained from CTM is the crushing load, and the failure may adapted due to the shear failure. The strength that may be developed by workable properly placed mixture of cement, aggregates and water is influenced by. So normally the concrete is made up of these elements only, cement, fine and coarse aggregate as well as the water. So that may, the workability is influenced by ratio of cement to mixing water. So the water cement ratio, again and again we are speaking, that leads to the major role. Ratio of cement to aggregate, so the weigh batching and volume batching, so the ratio might be different. So depends on the batching conditions, we should adopt the exact ratio so that the proper durability may arrive in the later cases. Grading the aggregates as well as fine and coarse aggregates as per coatal conditions IS 383, surface structure of the aggregate again from coatal conditions, shape, strength and stiffness of the aggregate. So initial prelim test can be carried out so that the grading and the materials can be satisfy the conditions so that it can be used in the project. Maximum size of the aggregate depends on the type of the structural element, we need to maximize the size of aggregate. Normally we used to have 20 mm in terms of slabs conditions, columns we used to adapt with 20 and 12.5 mm for mixture, so that the durability of structure and workability will also get increased. So depends on the condition of the concrete, we want to adopt the maximum size of the aggregate. Next is permeability of the concrete. So everyone knows what is the meaning of permeability. So some may enter, permit, like that. So the rates at which liquids and gases can move in the concrete are determined by its permeability. So you know that in terms of concrete, some liquids and gases in the air, it may move into the concrete and determines its permeability. So it is often refers to a root cause for lack of durability. So normally these words as mentioned by the dentist, root canal treatments, it may due to eating of some sugars, chocolates, not maintaining your teeth properly, so that the virus may enter into the root and develops and reduce the strength of the root. So that's what we used to mention. So this permeability of concrete, so some of these gases or some liquids may enter and it may have a root cause, so that the durability of the structure will automatically gets decreased by meaning of corrosion, the corroding the rods and developing some cracks, etc. Permeability affects the way in which the concrete resists external attack and the extent to which a concrete structure can be free of leaks. So permeability is mainly due to this external attack. So again, I said in the previous statement only, so the concrete structure can be free of leaks. So if your structure is free from leaks, automatically the structure will good in the structure will automatically good in durability of the concrete. So the permeability effect should not be taken care of. You should likewise, the material combination should be properly studied and it should be properly adapted. So by maintaining good workability, the structure durability will get automatically increased. So the permeability cannot be affected with the help of external attack. So you can save your structure. So by meaning of avoiding the cracks and also the leaks also. Theoretically, the introduction of aggregate of low permeability into cement paste, it is expected to reduce the permeability of the system. So normally, as in all the textbooks, it used to have a statement like that. So the aggregate with low permeability combining with the cement paste will reduce the permeability of the system. So internal attack, because the aggregate particles intercept the channels of flow and becomes, it take a circuitous route. So due to improper shape, imperfect shape, so that the aggregate may adapt some more spaces. So the movement of the concrete will get stuck. So as like that, it may take some other different route and it may take more, develop more voids in the concrete at the time of laying concrete. So it may also leads to the less durable and it may develop some cracks at the later stages by loading heavy conditions. Compared to neat cement paste, concrete with the same water cement ratio and degree of maturity should give lower coefficient of permeability. Instead of having, comparing with neat cement paste, that is the proper condition, concrete with same water cement ratio and degree of maturity is maintained at good level, should give the lower coefficient of permeability so that the durability of structure can be maintained. But in practice, it is seen from test data, it is not the case. The introduction of aggregate, particularly larger size of aggregates, increasing the permeability considerably. In some cases, it may also lead vice versa. So depends on the fielding condition, it may happen anything. So it may increase or decrease, depends on the larger size. In sometimes it may increase the strength, in some cases it may leads to some more voids so that it develops cracks. The use of pozzolanic materials in optimum proportion reduces the permeability of the materials. Again, by pozzolanic materials, n number of pozzolanic materials are available nowadays, starting from fly ash, metakaolin, etc. Even fibers nowadays upcoming, glass fibers. It depends on the economy of the project and depends on the importance of the project. We can adapt the pozzolanic materials in perfect manner so that it reduces the permeability of the concrete. This is evidently due to conversion of calcium hydroxide, otherwise soluble and reachable, into cementitious project. So this will be some of the chemical processes. Through air entrainment makes the concrete porous, when used up to 6%, makes the concrete more impervious, contrary to general belief. So air entrainment, so the concrete porous can be used up to 6%, so that the concrete will be more impervious. So that you know the meaning of impervious, so that in general belief, automatically the air entrainment methods will develop the good conditions.